a One Health approach to tackling the pock tapeworm. Diseases transmitted between animals and people are called zoonoses. Some of them are often forgotten or overlooked because they primarily affect the most vulnerable communities and usually cause mild or no disease in animals. For this reason, they are known as neglected zoonoses. Examples are the diseases caused by the parasite Taenia solium, also known as the pock tapeworm, which can result in seizures and epilepsy in people. In fact, in communities where the pock tapeworm exists, it causes up to 70% of epilepsies. Let's look at how this parasite is transmitted. The tapeworm lives in the intestines of humans, causing teniasis. When a person with teniasis defecates, the eggs of the tapeworm are released with their feces. If defecating outdoors, the environment, including vegetables and water, can become contaminated. If pigs eat tapeworm eggs present in feces or the environment, parasitic cysts develop in their muscles, causing porcine cysticercosis. But infected pigs don't usually get sick, and infected meat contains parasitic cysts that are not always easy to see. When a person eats undercooked or raw infected pork, the larval cyst develops into a tapeworm in their intestine, completing the transmission cycle. As teniasis is usually asymptomatic, infected people often don't realize they have a tapeworm. However, serious medical problems can arise if a person accidentally swallows parasite eggs released with the feces of a person infected with a tapeworm. This can occur due to bad hygiene after using the toilet or when consuming contaminated food or water. The parasites released from the eggs form cysts in tissues, causing human cysticercosis. These cysts often occur in the brain, triggering seizures and epilepsy. Yet, we can take simple measures to prevent this disease. What are they? Treating tapeworm infection in people with appropriate medicines. Using toilets or latrines to avoid infecting the environment, pigs, and other people. Keeping pigs in pens and following good farming practices. Vaccinating pigs and treating them simultaneously with oxfendazole. Inspecting the meat to identify parasitic cysts and discarding infected meat. Cooking pork thoroughly so no pink is seen. And very importantly, wash hands with soap and water after using the toilet. Also, rinse vegetables thoroughly or cook them. In conclusion, to control the pock tapeworm in an effective, efficient, and sustainable way, key sectors need to collaborate under the One Health approach. It's time to take action.